Those people that don't learn from history are going to repeat it again. What am I saying? I'm saying get close to God.
Get close to God.
Get close to God where even if it takes giving your life, you'll be able to do it. See, most people in the church, they're not ready to give their life for Christ. They ain't going to be no martyr. How you going to be a martyr don't even pray? It's getting down to that. What am I saying? I'm trying to get us to stop playing with God, playing with church. Be there on time. Get in prayer service. Get in your word. Get with somebody in a Bible study. Because America is filled with cults. Everywhere you go is a cult religion. The ones that you didn't think was a cult, come to find out they're nothing but cult religions. Anytime you're in religion and they're trying to control your thinking and your mind, that's a cult. You so messed up you can't even think on your own. You got to let somebody else dictate to you what to think. You really need to get saved. Because when you get saved, God gave you a new mind. He gave you a new heart. He gave you a new spirit.
Yes.
I said, if any man come after me, let him what? Deny who?
Himself.
Self is my biggest problem. I'm going to satisfy self. But you can't be no disciple. You have to kind of omit self to get in the right standing with God.
That's true.
Christianity, I don't have a Christianity that'll go and enslave and mistreat people. It's not called Christianity. It's called a walk with God. They're right. Christianity caused more wars. Islam too. More wars and hate. They call them disciples. Any disciples up in here?
Amen.
A disciple is a what? Learner. I learned so much, it didn't look like the more I learned, the more I find out I don't learn. And the more I want to learn, because it's so good.
Yes.
Knowledge about God and knowledge about myself.
Yes. Amen.
It ain't eating pork that defile your spirit. It's what comes out of your spirit. That's what Jesus said that defiles a man. Eating pork and eating sugar and all that stuff, now it can lessen your lifespan. But the main objective is God to get that inner man to make him born again. Make you a different person. How many want to be a different person?
Amen.
I want to be a different person. And you know what? The devil has a trick to try to bring us back to make us like what we used to be. Thank God I ain't what I used to be. Mm-hmm. And what's that other saying? I ain't all I should be. Something like that. However they had it. But I ain't the old Larry Ingram.
Yeah.
It's been a change in my life.
Amen.
I like to pray. I love to pray.
Amen.
I like to read the Word of God.
Yes.
Why? Because it changes me.
Uh-huh.
I think I was okay. Down to four, fornication, and I heard another voice. Let's get back to talk about the abundance and her delicacy. We live good, don't we?
Oh yeah.
Even poor people live good here.
Oh yeah.
People can live out on the street and people can give you a steak dinner if you want it. Most people out on the street, I talked to a friend of mine years ago before he passed away. He was out on the street because he didn't want to pay child support. Well, if you run around all these women and get them pregnant, you got to pay child support, man.
Right.
Ain't no easy way out.
No.
You just should have kept it zipped up.
Right.
Now you're going to have to pay. No girl gonna press charges on you now. She was so cute and bow-legged and all that stuff. Now you gotta pay. And because you don't wanna pay, you go live out on the street. That's terrible, isn't it? And God, all these years, he's been trying to get you to surrender your life to him so you won't have to go through all this stuff. You know, we make right decisions and we make wrong decisions, don't we? How many ever made a wrong decision? Still make them. You'll suffer for making a wrong decision. How many ever made a right decision? You'll suffer for making the right decision. Don't fool yourself. And the devil gonna make sure he gonna put it on you when you make the right decision. But be a good cheer. God's gonna bring you through it.
Amen.
That's the good news.
Hallelujah.
Ooh, every trial, every test. I fought, I couldn't fight no more. And God stepped in. But we say, when, Lord, when? How long, Lord, how long? Just wait. God has got his own appointed time. Those children that you've been praying for, that they get delivered, just keep praying. They're going to get delivered.
Amen.
But you got to stay before God.
Yeah.
Don't argue with them. Don't fuss with them. Uh-huh. It ain't going to do no good, because all they're looking for is some fuel to fight with.
Yeah.
And you keep providing the fuel so y'all can get them down. Let it go.
There you go.
You're dealing with grown kids now.
Oh,
they got a mind of their own.
That's true.
But I tell you what, it'll work. Prayer will work.
Amen. Prayer will work.
Prayer will work. They'll start calling back to the house. Mama, how y'all doing?
Uh-huh.
Yeah. How Papa doing? Or what's up? Or, come on. Just keep praying.
Uh-huh. That's true.
God know how to bring them in.
Yeah.
Don't you bring them in. Let God bring them in.
Amen.
Come on here. I'm almost about to do. Okay, where was I at? Number four said, and I heard another voice from heaven saying, come out!
Uh-huh.
Say, come out.
Come out.
Of her.
Of her, yes.
My people. Mm-hmm. Well, if God calls us out of America, rapture us out as they teach, then we're going for a reward.
Uh-huh.
You're not going to judgment. You're going for a reward for what you've done here on planet Earth.
Mm-hmm.
While we were here. You know, life is very short, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
I was getting a haircut the other day, and the guy asked me how old I was. He said, man, you look like you're about 45. I said, I wish. I said, you're getting warm. Keep on guessing. He said, oh, man, you ain't no more than about 50.
Uh-huh.
I said, I wish.
Yeah.
Keep on guessing. He said, now you couldn't be no more than 60. I said again, I wish. But I told him how old he was, his eyes, fuck you, what? I say, I'll say this, God is keeping me.
Amen.
Just like he's keeping you.
Yes.
Who said, because you get old, you got to be decrepit?
Mm-hmm.
Huh? No, you ain't. You can walk. You can look good.
Yes, amen.
Huh?
Uh-huh.
Yes.
You know, when God get ready to take his people, you want to leave here gracefully.
Amen.
Well, however you leave.
Yeah.
The saints fall asleep.
Uh-huh.
We just go to sleep, that's all. Waiting for the resurrection.
Yeah.
Resurrection of what? The body.
Yeah.
Cremate you, if you will. It don't matter. I know my cousin was with my uncle. You know, I guess back then he ain't number 4 or 5 years older than me. He's my uncle. But anyway, one of my other uncle was much older years, but he died. And, you know, he didn't have no insurance. And I said, well, man, you know, I ain't bothered me and all this. What we gonna do, man? And you know, he's headstrong. He said, man, go in there and get you some kitchen matches and some kerosene. I said, man, you shouldn't be talking about your brother like that. He said, well, didn't have no insurance. He should have got insurance.
That's tough. Yeah.
He spent all his money drinking whiskey. Mm. So much for that. What am I saying? Y'all get your insurance right,
man.
Yeah. Huh? I don't want nobody cremating me. Let me be buried.
Uh-huh.
Well, I'm not saying that you're not saved because you get cremated. They say it's more economical now.
Uh-huh.
One man was supposed to have been cremating people, and he had a funeral home full of bodies. They found him.
Uh-huh.
Let's get back on this. And I heard another voice from heaven saying, come out of her, my people. How are we going to come out? We stuck.
Mm-hmm.
Are we?
Mm-hmm.
It says, come out of her. My people, that ye be not partakers of her what?
Sins.
Uh-huh. Her sins. Well, God sent judgment to Egypt, didn't he? And God's people came out.
Yeah,
Pharaoh was a mean, not Pharaoh, he was a mean, evil man. And God had to deal with it. God sent 10 plagues before he released God's people. He turned what? He turned Egypt what? Pitch black.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, Ra couldn't help him then. Where's your God Ra at? He's supposed to be the sun. Where's the light at, Ra? It's turned pitch black, I guess, for a day or two, how high it was. It was so black, listen. It was so black that they couldn't even, if you had a flashlight, it wouldn't do no good. You talking about some black, that must have been hell, man. That's where hell gonna be, so black you can't see nothing. A flashlight, spotlight, it ain't gonna do no good, it's just pitch black. And then on the end, he took the firstborn. Could it be that America is upon a curse? The tornadoes, the floods, the earthquakes that are coming. Could it be something that just happened? Or could it be the judgment of God? I've been in a tornado. High winds and all that. I thought my house was going to blow off. You know, it was so close, I guess. And then, in Oklahoma, been in an earthquake. Were y'all in that last earthquake? Did y'all feel it? I said, what in the world's going on? The house is shaking. Oh my God, what's that? I don't have to go to California to be in an earthquake. You got them right here. God is what allowed judgment to come to those folk that don't want to serve Him. Those that reject the way of God are going to fall into a dangerous situation. God's people fall in dangerous situations, but we always get delivered.
Yes.
At least I do. Be partaker of our sins, and that you receive not of her plague. What is a plague?
Help me out. What's a plague? Y'all Bible students, what's a plague? Come on.
A what? A disease. Didn't they just have a COVID, but not a disease? They got something else coming worse than COVID. COVID, like First Lady was saying, COVID was a fear thing. First thing the doctor do when you go to, most of them that want to make money off it, they put you in fear. Oh, you got cancer. Mm-hmm. How you know it's cancer? And the first thing you do, you faint. And the first thing they want to do is put you on chemo. Why is chemo so important? Cost is money. Every time you go in there, they make $5,000-$10,000 off you. White doctor put it on the internet. I seen. He said they putting chemo and doing it mostly on who? Black people. Most black people don't have these diseases. They just want to make money off you. And y'all still won't serve God. Just because somebody see a mask, they don't mean it's cancer. Now they want to go in there and do a biopsy on you. They're getting you set up.
Yeah.
Now he's going to give you all them poisonous drugs. Mm-hmm. Them drugs got you where you don't know where you're coming or going. Come on here. Put you on 5 drugs, and then you don't know which one is killing you.
Yeah.
Then you go back. My wife was telling me, she said, my dad-in-law, he was saying they gave me some herbs. And he said, he didn't know nothing about that. He said, that one right there is really good. It wasn't a drug, it was a herb. But the doctor kept on feeding drugs because we didn't have a knowledge. They tell you now with drugs, they're fatal. They can be fatal. But if y'all know, if you're in pain, man, you take anything to get rid of the pain. I don't condemn nobody. I had some pain, I pulled a groin, I think it was. I was in so much pain, I went to the doctor, and the doctor gave me a big old jar. Ibuprofen. He said, take, because ain't nothing I can do. I couldn't even walk, man. And you know what? I took about all of them because I was in pain. Of her plagues. See, we what we're doing, we are not giving people the total package in a church. This message is to make you think, to make you and I what? Do better in our walk with God.
Yes.
I'm not up here trying to make you happy. Because if I'm trying to make you happy every Sunday, I'm doing you an injustice. I want to make you think and make you be a better believer in Christ.
Amen.
That's what it's all about.
Yes.
Can the church say amen?
Amen.
Can the church say amen?
Amen.
Say yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Say yes.
Yes.
I'm getting there. All right. We're going to close out with Psalms 46. Someone give me Psalms 46. While you and I are going through trials and tests, we've got to remember about the troubles that we go through. We got to remember that God is in the midst of our trouble.
Yes.
And I know you want to call the preacher and the first lady, and that's good, so we can pray for you, but God is with you. Mm-hmm. What does Psalm 46:1 say?
God is our refuge.
God is our what?
Refuge.
He's our protection. He's our shield. God is.
Yes.
Not trying to be or will be. He is right now.
Yes.
We serve our own time God right now. Sometimes you pray and ask God to touch certain situations in your life and look like it don't, nothing happened. Uh-huh. But you just keep going.
Yes.
And after a while you'll say, hey, I don't feel this no more.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. Hey, this condition I'm going through, these people that I'm fighting with, hey, they're not fighting no more.
Amen.
Why? Because God is working the problem out.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. You ain't got to get on the phone and cuss people out no more.
Thank you.
But then you said, I'm going to give them a piece of my mind. Now I told the Lord, and I mean, I asked God when this man come to the bus stop and started cussing me out and called me all them ill names. And I just sit there. And I said, I asked God to help me. But I said, God, if you get on this bus, you see that fire extinguisher over there? I'm going to make sure this is the last bus he get on there. I asked God, please don't let this man get on the bus. I think he's going to curse me out in front of these kids. No, you not. And God knew that.
Yeah.
Get out and cuss me and call me out. I'm going to say, praise the Lord. Praise the Lord, brother. Yeah, uh-huh. You think you're going to get on in and hit me side of my head? You got another thing coming.
Yes, sir. Yes,
sir. After I hit you side of the hip, that fire sting, I'm going to say, praise the Lord, brother. Huh? But see, God heard my request.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
And I was honest that day. Please, God, don't let me do something that I don't want to do.
Yes.
But if you think he's going to get in and hit me beside my head, y'all better call Jax. Get on that radio and say, y'all better send Jack out here.
Yeah.
Notice I didn't say him, so I said Jax. What did it say? God is what?
Our refuge.
And what?
Strength.
Strength! Anybody need strength here?
Yeah.
Amen.
You know, the wife got sick last week. Oh, my God. I mean, she was sick, man. First time I ever seen her that sick. And I just kind of stayed there. I just prayed. Because, you know, when a person really sick, ain't too much you can do with the sickness she had. Just have to stay there and wait and pray and trust God.
Amen.
She didn't get delivered just like that, but after about 3 or 4 hours, she started coming through.
Amen.
That's God.
Yes.
Hmm?
Yes.
God is my refuge and strength, a very present help in the time of what?
Trouble.
Yes. Anybody go through trouble up in here?
Oh, yes.
Oh, my God.
Yes.
It's trouble on the job, man. Oh, Tommy.
Yes.
These people, you heard some of these people is crazy. Ooh, I never seen such fanaticism in my life. One guy come to work and said, don't you say a so-and-so thing to me, none of y'all.
What do you mean?
I ain't said, nobody said nothing to him. Just crazy. Well, nobody said nothing to him, and after a while, it chilled out. Just crazy. But you got to deal with these crazy people. God has put you and I down here to deal with these fanatics.
Yeah.
Just don't you be one.
Amen. That's true. Yeah.
What does it say? A very present having a time of trouble?
Therefore will not be feared.
I ain't going to be afraid if what? Read on.
Though the earth be removed.
Though the earth tilt on its axis.
Uh-huh.
Oh my God. If the earth tilt just a 1/16 of an inch off its axis, we got chaos! Some said, so what? God is in control.
Yes.
Read on.
And though the mountains be carried into the midst of the sea.
Ooh, that sounds like a tsunami, don't it?
Mm.
They say California's right on the verge of a big, massive earthquake with a tsunami. They said the Madrid fault line that splits Tennessee and Illinois, it can erupt. They said it erupted in the 1800s, and it was so powerful that the Mississippi River went backwards.
That's
my God. Even through all that, God promised to be with us.
Yes, amen.
Oh, that's good news. Now, you ought to be shouting out.
Hallelujah.
God gonna save them unsaved loved ones of unsaved children. He's gonna bring it out.
Hallelujah.
His way.
His way.
All you and I gotta do is trust Him. Lord, I feel pain today. My back is hurting. My sciatic nerve is getting ready to cut up. I'll get up and say, in the name of Jesus. I ain't going to sit too long. I better not see that sciatic nerve. Somebody got sciatic nerve problems. John 16:33. We're going to close out. 16:33. Y'all been such a beautiful audience. I appreciate y'all. St. John 16:33. What did it say? I close my Bible. I'm going to let somebody else read it.
These things have I spoken unto you.
These things, listen, this is what the Lord said. These things have I spoken unto you.
That in me you might have peace.
That in me, oh, I like that. That in Yah, Jesus, Yeshua, the Son of God.
Yes.
El Shaddai, the bright and morning star. In me you might have what?
Peace.
Anybody want peace?
Amen.
I know I was doing some work the other day, and I was right in the midst of it. And man, I was doing so many things, and my cousin called. He talked to him, but I said, I can't talk to him now. Come on. Had too many things going right in the midst of it. I couldn't talk. Uh-huh. Anybody ever been in a situation like that? Where you can't talk to him? Come on back later. Thank God I got an understanding why. First thing come to my natural mind. Tell that that I can't. No, I said no. I'm not gonna go that way. I'm gonna be nice. I'm gonna be what Jesus said. He said that you and I can have what?
Peace.
God wanna give peace in that home. When husband and wife not getting along, it's time for prayer.
Yes, it's true. Huh?
Some folks go and check the door. Don't come in here. Leave me alone. People say, oh, yeah, but y'all been married a long time. Well, you've been married a long time because you put up with one another.
That's right.
Yeah.
That's true.
She put up with me. I know that's a hard task. She almost stumbled and broke her ankle because of my shoes. In the floor. So what did she do? She threw them out the door. Come on. Hey, don't be throwing my stuff out. Let me pick them up when I get ready to pick them up. Well, it don't work like that. Pick them up. The wife, I guess she caught me. She bought a new pot pan, I'm going to confess. And somehow the pot burned up. I had some. I didn't confess it. I said, well, something must have happened. It turned the color like that. Yeah, I burned up the pot, Lord. She wasn't here. She's on vacation. She comes, something wrong with my pot. I said, I don't know what's wrong with it. Should have been a lie. You know good well what's going on. A liar. Come on here. Then I finally confessed. It may have got overheated. I think a little shit. Come on. Yeah, I did. Yeah, I did. I'm like Perry Mason. Yeah, I did. Maybe I can buy you another pot, bitch. Oh, God. It's little things that start stuff in the house. People talking about unconfessed sin with God, unconfessed sin with one another. Oh, well. Read on. I'm about to. Come on.
In the world ye shall have tribulation.
I'm going to have what?
Tribulation.
It's going to be peaches and cream.
It said tribulation, troubles, trials.
Everybody got a story, don't we? Everybody got a story. I got pain, you got pain, so who's first? Anybody got hip pain? Come on in. Anybody got allergies? Come on, y'all. We all got something wrong with us, don't we?
Oh, yeah, it's always something.
I know AJ said, man, I'm hurting, I don't feel good. I said, but that's why I prayed for him.
Yes, amen.
Huh? Prayer. I'm here because y'all praying for me, man. I'm walking Amen. Good, better. Come on here.
Amen.
Let y'all pray for me. I appreciate it.
Amen.
Y'all prayers is powerful.
Amen.
You just don't know it. Maybe God don't want you to know it. You might get the big head.
Oh, Lord.
God answering all your prayers on other people. Come on here.
Amen.
Your day's coming too.
Amen.
Read on. We gotta go. Come on.
But be of good cheer.
Be of what?
Good cheer.
Oh, I can shout now. Come on here. Be of good cheer, ladies and gentlemen. Y'all give it up. Come on and praise God. Hallelujah. In spite of what you're going through, be of good cheer. Hallelujah. One of the worst things, and one of the best ways to destroy the enemy is start giving God praise.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah!
I'm in pain, but hallelujah!
Yeah.
Who cares?
That's true.
God cares.
God
cares. I'm delivered.
Amen.
Say I'm delivered.
I'm delivered.
Is that all of that?
I have overcome the world.
I have overcome the world. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. As we close out,
yes.
You a winner.
Yes.
As we say, top dog, you the top, you the one.
Yeah.
Why? Because God is on your side.
Yes.
And God is fighting your battle right now.
Yes. Yes.
Father, thank you for an opportunity to come for this great congregation. My friends out there in YouTube land, bless them, bless their families.
Yes.
Bless those that are sick. God, I curse cancer, heart trouble right now. Lord, open up them arteries right
now. Right
in
now.
Jesus' name.
Jesus.
Open up the minds of you people, God.
Yes.
That we can praise you and thank you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Hi friends, my name is Pastor Larry Ingram along with my wife Carolyn. Come join us on this network for preaching, teaching, and our healing services.
Come join us and be blessed.